Bum!
For Fabiel and everybody's grandfather.
Okay, have a good trip. Yeah, thank you very much. Okay, bye-bye. And it was Richard Brecht.
Yes, Richard Brecht.
Okay.
The Bok saga is based on the sounds of the root language, told in the root language, the Van language, the Finnish language, which is based on the sound of root, and the English language, the language that came about under the ice time. And this story is an enormous story going on for 20 years, starting from 1984. So we can find out how this thing is which is going on in this time called Paradise time, when the axle of this earth is straight and hell is the North Pole. In this time we roll for many million years, according to the Bok saga or Wijnemeunen mythology, in this Paradise time, up to one point where we come to a calamity on this planet. We change the axle of the earth, it fall over about 30 degrees, and now start one period called Altland Ice, all the land ice. And this means all the land north from the Alps and the Pyrenees in one ring around the world, which made that these people became separated from this Aser living in Uudenma, and the people living in the tropical part of the world south from this ring of ice that came on the planet. Uudenma remained ice free, which made that this was actually Altland Ice, because it was the only area where people were living. This period lasted about 50 million years and made that these people in Uudenma became white people with blonde and blue eyes, as opposed to the people living outside from this ring who remained tropical people, brown people with brown and black eyes. The whole system, the whole evolution of people was completely based on the nature and the sound from the root language, which consists of 29 sounds, where every sound has a meaning, on which this whole Bok family saga is based. 937 years ago, the year 1050, when through all kinds of happenings, changes in the history and the pattern of how these people, which were before rolling from one point to every corner of the planet with one breeding and information system, the information and breeding system is changing everywhere around the planet, and we come to one happening, the year 1050, that destroyed Uudenma. All these Aser who were living here were killed.
We call it Fiendland, because Fiend in Latin languages means the end. No? Wow. Completely finished people.
Mystery spread its cloak across the sky. We'd lost our way. Shadows fell from trees. They knew why. Then through the leaves a light broke through. A path
oh, so
Dynamite.
Ah. Look how soft this is right here. This.
That's the Repart TV.
Yeah. Yeah. It could be my last shot on here.
Monday he would be able to drill three holes and three holes and blow the thing out.
On Monday?
On Monday.
What's he going to do today?
He hasn't got the equipment.
Whoa! I never thought I'd
not get to be a million. I never thought I'd get to be the thing that all his other children see.
Look at me. Well, I tell you, man, I think it's pretty strange that all these rocks are set in here like this. You know that? I mean, each time I dig through here, I break off a little rock, a little rock, a little rock. This is solid. This is totally solid. There's a crack right down here. There's a lot of mud in between each one of these rocks. It's like as if something about it is just a little bit, doesn't seem right, you know? I mean, you can't move a mountain like this with a piece of meat. Just in the corner, you know, they're just coming out of this corner. That's where they're coming out of. The road.
You notice it's a different color down here.
Yeah, this is the bedrock. Yeah, this is the bedrock, or the natural. It's solid granite, and this one was placed after this one was placed. And we're going to find, if we can, the edge. That's why we want to get rid of this stuff here. This is all loose. It was put in by man. Watch. See what I mean? Just keep it out there. You notice it all just comes out. Like
watch
bricks.
Your toes, man. Watch your toes.
Markers, where did you go?
Sam's. Sounds hollow.
I know, it sounds hollow too, doesn't it? All of this sounds completely hollow.
That'll go now.
I don't know, it's really wedged.
Näin kuoli Afrika 1000 vuotta sitten. Ja kaikki ihmiset menivät surmakalleen. Jokainen päätti itse kuolemansa, eikä kukaan kuollut. Sellaista ei ollutkaan. Vaan jos sä onnettomuudessa kukut jossain merellä, niin silloinhan sä kuoli. Sun vastaa sun tahtoa. Eli jokainen valmistelee itse, kun huomaa, että se ei enää nyt kävele hyvin. Ja talvella se huomaa, niin hän päättää kesällä jonkun. Ainoastaan kesäisin kuoltiin aikaisemmin. Ainoastaan kesäisin.
Mutta jos kesällä kuoli, niin
ja niin kuoli kaikki muutkin ihmiset täällä. Se on vasta kun katoliset tuli.
But I trust on this Napoleon. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, he's good, man.
But anyway, it's nice to make all this different. Guy who worked for us. All these round stones here, his hand put it there. Haha, I said, that's very nice.
That was the first one.
The second was that we find one mark. I didn't know that mark, but we find one mark on the wall. 5R7, no,
five,
yeah, five R7 squares inside, and 5R7, we call it Sakki Kuvio in Finnish language, Sakki Kuvio, Sakki Kuvio.
Check.
So 5R7 means 5R7 Sakki Kuvio. 5 means 5, 7 means 7. 7. 7. 7 is 7 and 5 is 5. So we have 5R7 Sakki kuva ruutu. This is in this one language, this Inman language. No? 5R7, 7 is the sun number. And 7 is Uuden. So we call 5R7, 5R Uuden merkki. And that was for me very nice because for the first it showed that there had been people, you know, leaving one mark. So when we start, I mean, Amy, I had to start after 1,000 years. So they know anyway that I get this problem. They must have been doing. Because it said 987 that that Bock who lives after 1,000 years, he has to do this job. Actually, I have done so much, I only get reports in Helsinki, Ragnar's apartment. But this mark, these R7, these are wooden mark, was for me the second mark. Well, after digging master start to tell that the corners in these shivas are corner, because stone is round, the natural stone is always round. You can't find them. You can't find them in this square. They must lay down there. Now after I get one information that they've been finding the stair shiva. Yeah, you must jump in all the rocks apart. But later on they said that no, and I took it also away. And they started to try to find the hole in the Kuperivuori side. Because the temple is inside in Kuperivuori. So of course you think it must be there. And so they find one little thing in there, and I get reported now we've been finding on Kuperivuori side one door. And in this door is Rapakivi. And this Rapakivi means that it must be on the earth. It's the sun, the wet, the cold, the thing make Rapakivi. So it can't be according to these digging people who dig there. They say that Rapakivi can't be in any other place than on the earth, because they've been digging in Lapinmaa, they've been making tunnels, they've been making metros, they've been making all these things. And he count all these things to me, and like half an hour he was talking to me what he has done in his life, this guy, Hakulinen, and his friend Tiainen, two guys who know much about everything about stone. One day he counted me all these stones, what is this granite, grey granite and red granite and consistence of different, yes, you know, there in the telephone. So he wanted to prove to me this Rapakivi, really heavy, really heavy. Yes, I call, now we come to Rapakivi. Rapakivi was that round stone, the mark, the shivas, and the Rapakivi. Now this Rapakivi was something I could tell other people so they could also understand. So everybody ran around in Helsinki asking for Rapakivi, people telling me I go to the library straight away to talk about Rapakivi, and one said yes, I go to some other place to find Rapakivi. Because this Rapakivi is really many meters under where sun and ice and wetness, sun and things should have been making this TV Rapakivi. So for us, we have been talking about Rapakivi since then.
You haven't had an opportunity yet to really learn any of the meanings of the letters. And here's the O. Mm-hmm. And here's the L.
So.
Yeah, so now this ring is making S-O-L with the O in the center. Now if you put the P, the ring, and the sun is going around and it's making the shadow on this pole, which is making the Q. And if you know that N means knowledge and North Pole, then you can say N-O-P-Q, knowledge of the ring and the pole, is quadrat. Quadrat means mathematics.
That's a sundial, the ring of this pole, right? And at the top of the world on a hill, this the sun never went overhead, it went around. So it was always casting a shadow here. Whereas where we live, it would be 12 o'clock when there was no shadow. But here the sun's going around like this at the top of the world. So it was always casting a shadow at one place or the other. Like our moon, at nighttime you watch it go across the sky instead of over.
So it was always forming a cube?
Always forming, yeah. A Q, just from wherever, which way you want to look at it.
So?
The women have the quadrants, they have the mathematics, because they did this whole astrology situation. This crystal balls. they could go up and actually put a black dot everywhere there was a white spot. And then when they opened the room up, you could see the whole star system on the ceiling.
Run that by again. How did they
put it in like a dome.
Yeah.
Okay. And they had this crystal ball.
What do you mean putting
a black
dot?
You see them, well, when this light, in which the room's dark, you close all the windows up, so it's dark in here. And you just have this one candle which represents Udin.
Mm-hmm.
When it hits this prisma, it shoots this astrologi.
Mm-hmm.
So you'd have these white dots everywhere there was the star system. And so you could go up with a black pen in this dark room, and everywhere there was a white dot, you could black it out. And then then you could blow the candle out, open the door up, and let the light in. And then you'd have little black dots all over the whole ceiling and everything. This was a star system. Because they could never see the stars in the top of the world. It was daylight all the time.
Hmm.
So, but they knew all about the stars. But here, the sun was going around and around and around. It was always daylight, see.
And the origin of the crystal balls?
They made these things. This logic on paper. The story is a little different.
But astrologic. Troll is, again, can be truer, right? You can rearrange the letters. Hmm. Any way in which the letters can be arranged is valid. So you say as, tro, logic. You're also saying the logic of tour. This whole
the logic has to come from the astro.
Actually, they said,
then people, the first thing when these first people were living, the only thing they could see was this world and the stars. Yeah, and that's what was needed to orientate. You need stars.
It came through the sperm, through fear. It was in this information from the very beginning.
I heard the question posed yesterday and never heard an answer. How does the magnetic North Pole fit in with the current North Pole, with the previous North Pole?
Hmm. Well, there was only one maypole, Ma Pole, like the maypole dance.
Mm-hmm.
And Ma is the earth and pole is the pole. It's the earth pole. And so today we have this one here, which we're kind of wobbling. We're off the course in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
And we also have this North Pole. So we have two poles. But in the beginning, this hell is 30 degrees off the top. So it was actually one May pole in the beginning.
Have you heard of the wobble?
Yeah, the earth is
wobble. And the, well,
where's the magnetic
because
pole?
We're not on magnetic North Pole because of the tilt.
Magnetic north at a certain direction.
Because we've tilted 30 degrees. We wobble.
Because we're not, hell's not the top.
So
of the
we're our relationship
so we have a north
to everything is shifting about 30 degrees.
Yeah, I looked on the map yesterday and the magnetic north pole is at 30 degrees.
Yeah,
over in the
exactly.
Canadian side somewhere.
Sounds would be up of it. Right?
Who's the heart? Who's the heart? Who's the love? That is the most easiest to understand for a child. For sure.
For sure.
A pure child.
Yeah. For sure.
But the child is always going to the mother and the father and lying on their heart.
To get back to the rhythm.
Steady rhythm. He's all excited, but he knows that there is
a good, strong, mature pump.
That's home. Select out a myth. Say, the one that I'm using to begin with is Cupid and Psyche. Relationship of love and the human soul. If you select out the myth and then use those names, and when the ring, you follow those line patterns with that particular name, such as Cupid or Venus or whatever, and then you put in the proper colors, it actually gives you the archetypal images associated with those myths in an optical illusory form so that they change in front of your eyes. Because the shades, like a shadow is really a shade, yeah? So the shades of the colors create this effect in the retina of your eye, which gives you this optical illusion thing. That's actually what the forefront of my investigation is now. These are preliminary works that I did a year or so ago on that.
Really? That's amazing.
Like, here's the one, here's the two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, Right. And of course, the center ring is the same.
I see.
This understanding in the 20th century now?
Can we make this now?
It's 18th century.
Can we make this all come true? She asked.
No, I can take the example from that where people did realize by themselves. I will always talk about the past, the good from the past, where they can realize by themselves what we live in now. I can take the positive part when people stayed in one little house called Savupirti. Savupirti is in Finland, we had Savupirtiläisiä, Savupirti people. And these people who lived there, they had the rights to take as much wood as they want from the wood. They could have as much agriculture they want for their own use. They could have as many domestic animals they want for their own use. So they could live in the nature and use the nature. And they didn't have to go to church, and they didn't have to pay tax, these people. It was only living there in the nature.
These are the trails.
And every autumn, they counted in the villages how many people we have in the village from the Savupirti class of people. So they built as many Savupirti as they need to be inside over the winter. And in every Savupirti they put 12 women and 12 men. 24 people in one room, staying 6 months in the winter. Because everything snow and ice here, so what should they do outside? So they had one system that 4 in 10, like yesterday, they all should have gone in. And 4 in 4 they are coming out. And after 4 in 4 they make all this agriculture what they need. They take this wood what they need. And they have this domestic animal they need to get milk. And there is the horse, the cow, the sheep, the goat, the pig, and the chicken. This domestic animal we can have here in the cold. We don't have to make any heat for them. They are staying there in 30 degree cold, so we don't have to care about, we only give them food, these animals. They are Arctic animals. No, 4 in 10 they went inside, always 12 women and 12 men. And now they stay 12 women and 12 men in 6 months inside in this house. They have one fire in the middle. So the fireplace is very hot in the daytime, it's very hot inside. So they had no clothes. Even when it was 30 degrees cold outside, they didn't use so much clothes because this fire always there. Like we are here also now, exactly the same.
Same way.
So we don't need, so they could be very natural inside, these men and women, 12 and 12. They divide the fire in two, that the female had the right to use the fire and the masculine had the right to use the fire. When the masculine used the fire, he took down his bear skins they have hanging on the wall, 12 of them. And the bear's head of the bear skin was like one pillow, so the man was making 12 bear skins around the fire. And there we men was lying down and Kela, all kind of nice thing, and we had the communication with one ring of men inside in this house. When the female had the right, the men took away their bearskins and the female came into the fire to make the food and their part from this thing. When the men was lying there, the men had to make their tea by themselves. They couldn't give order to this woman that now you make tea. They had to make this thing by themselves, so actually when the men had the fire, the woman was completely free. She had completely free. She had nothing to, nobody could tell them, you will do that, do that, do that. She become like outside of the ring. And when the woman go through to the fire, the men was completely free. But the men went out in the winter to take from the storehouses all this thing what the woman was making from. They could go for fishing in the winter, because they had one big hole. It is ducks, but maybe the, anyway, so they divide this in two inside. And in March, always 6 of these women get one child. Because there's 12 women, usually every second year they get one child. So they had to get it in March, the child. because if you get it in January, they should have died. It was completely dark, no sun, no light, nothing. So they were all the people was made 24 in 6. That was the breeding day. So all the children had to be born in the Savupirti. In 1 week time, the children came out. And now it's completely dark inside, I think no sun, but in March the first sun is coming. And when the first sun coming on the wall of the Savupirti, that small hole in the wall with one plug. So every mother took away the, when it comes sun on the wall, she took away the plug, and in from this wall come like one spotlight of lights and make one ring on the floor. So there she was sitting and taking the sunlight through this small hole. If they should have been opening the big hole for ventilation, the wind should have been coming in and all children should have died. So they had to make them 24 in 6 to be born at the same time for them to get the first sun coming on the wall, even when it's 30 degrees cold outside in March, to open the plug, to get in the light, to take the sun. And in the summer, the mothers went out to take the sun, so the child becomes strong, so it could survive the next winter cold, dark, ice winter. So we had one saying that if the woman don't get the sperm 24 in 6, they don't get it in the whole year. Because they had to get the sperm inside just that day for the nature. Otherwise it couldn't go round this day. And this period I like to tell. It tells a lot of things, this thing. The Savupirti people in Finland. It's tell to them, and they all like it. And it's so primitive. And today when you sit in your box in the fifth floor with the pink bedroom, the TV room, the child room, and the balcony for the baby, there's a little bit thinking that it has been changed. But I don't have to tell the changing. They find it out by themselves.